Hey guys, welcome to a new video. Today I'm going to show you a video with the new DALL 3 that has been inputted into GPT so we can create better designs in Canva. Essentially, you're going to be maximizing GPT, DALL 3, and Canva all into one. So let's go ahead and get the video rolling. So a few days ago, I actually tried this and it didn't actually work. My GPT has not been updated yet. It is updated now. And I'll be sharing this because you guys can do the exact same thing. So I actually did this a few times. And basically, GPT has now DALL technology within it, where it can read and understand and see essentially an image-based file. So I uploaded an image here and I said, what is this? And it actually tells me what it is. It looks like a hot dog with mustard on it. And then what I told it to do is give me quotes or sayings that would apply well for this design. And the thing that's interesting about this is before what I had to do was I had to describe the actual design to GPT. I couldn't just upload an image, and when I was able to upload an image before, it didn't really fully understand exactly what the art was. All it could do was see the dimensions of the image, the pixels, things like that, but it couldn't really tell what the image is. But now it actually can, which makes things a little bit easier. So instead of now sitting here describing what the image is, the GPT can get a full analysis of the image and then create quotes or texts or play on words or whatever you want to call it that I can apply to the design. And you guys could see here, I made a few of these type of t-shirt designs before where I have a graphic and then I have a clever play on words that could apply to that specific design. So here, for example, I have a picture of a Yeti. Anybody who's been watching my channel for a while has seen this before, where I say, Yeti or not, here I come, right? Here's another one that says, don't be salty, and it's like a pack of French fries with the French fry packaging that's like in a kind of like a namaste yoga type pose, like inner peace type pose, don't be salty, right? See the kind of play on words? So there's different things here. We have a moon shot, like a moo with a cow. You guys know what I'm talking about here. We have cash cow. There's a lot of different things here. And I'll be honest, all of these ideas I never came up with myself. I just described them to the AI. And the cool thing about this whole kind of system is that with proper tagging or clever tagging, I don't have to tag the exact statement that's written on the design, whether it be on a marketplace platform or even on my own website, but I could still get attention. And since it is a clever type design, I can get sales. So how can you guys do this yourself? Well, like I said, it got easier because DALL has now been imported within GPT. So these different graphics that you're seeing here, I've uploaded them into Fantasy Labs, so I'll just be using some of them. So here's a picture of a dinosaur that's laying down, and it's, I guess you could say, sleeping, or maybe it's knocked out, or whatever the case may be. And I asked it to do the same thing here, and it came up with these 10 different sayings, right? We have snoozosaurus on board. We have roar means I'm sleepy in dino. We have dreaming of prehistoric days. Too tired to terrorize. We have nap first, roar later. We have catching some Z's before the next adventure. Chilling like a reptilian. I woke up like this, tired. Beauty rest in progress. And Yonosaurus Rex. I think out of all of these, my favorite one is the last one. The current text that I had on it, I think I could pull it up here. Let's see. From predator to pillow is what I had. But I think I could change it. I think my favorite one is Yonosaurus Rex. And I wanted to go ahead and see what can the AI do with this exact design. Like I said, we have here, it says, don't be salty. Let's go ahead and test it. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go into GPT here, and I'm going to download the image. So the image, let's see here, it's on page 19. So I'll go over here to page 19, hit download. Okay. And then once the image is downloaded, I'm just going to simply upload it to GPT. So that's exactly what I'm going to do now. So I'm going to go here to drop down, go ahead and upload this, and then I'm going to say, what about this one, right? And all you have to do is create the prompt once where you ask it to describe the play on words type text. And since it's all saved under one communication line, you could just keep giving it, keep feeding it new images, and it will be doing the same thing for you. So Here it says, for this, an adorable image of a fry container character with starry eyes. Here are some helpful quotes or playful quotes. It says, eyes on the fries. That's actually a really good one. I'm surprised. I didn't think it was going to be that good. We have unfrygettable. That's a good one too. Fry Nally the weekend. Oh, finally the weekend. Okay. That one's a good one too, right? This is the cool thing about this, guys, is I can take a graphic like this and I can apply it to multiple different one of these like play on word type lines. So here we have finally the weekend. We have eyes on the fries. We have starry eyed snack. Okay. That one's a little iffy. Unfrygettable. Okay. We have I'm all that and a bag of fries, serving looks and fries, hot and golden just like me, Friday vibes every day, that's a good one too, crunch time all the time, keep calm and eat fries, that's a good one as well, right? So you could see here, the AI clearly knows what's going on. It has this calm yoga type vibe, the cute type of art. This is really cool. I'm going to go ahead and let's just make a basic one, like keep calm and eat fries. So I would do it like this, right? So because of the font is like this childish, cute vibe type font, I'm just going to use the same, or design, I'm going to use the same type of font that can match it, which is my font here. And I'm going to go over here and I'm going to type in, let me see here, let me get rid of this. Let me see, keep calm and eat fries. So I'll go over here, I'll type in keep calm. Just like this. I'll take the text, maybe minimize it a little bit, just so it can all fit within the canvas, right? Something like that. And then I'll take the text, duplicate it, right? And I'll put the and symbol, eat fries, something like that, right? And this design can work because it's understood what about the design and is basically the message that that's being sent, right? And this could work on a t-shirt, this could work on you name it, on a poster, it could potentially work, a sticker, it could definitely work. And once again, if you have your own website, it could definitely work as well, which by the way, I have many videos on my YouTube channel recommending and showing you guys how to build websites and do all that. So no matter what platform it is, and I'll leave links in the description if you want to check out those videos. But yeah, it's pretty cool. And with all this being said, right, you can take the same graphic and create multiple versions of the designs. So this one says, keep calm and eat fries. I did that version, right? I could go here, finally the weekend, right? Eyes on the fries. Since, guys, these designs are non-trademarked in any kind of way, I'm happy to show a tutorial where I go ahead and upload these to Redbubble or TeePublic or however you want to see it. So if you're interested in that, let me know in the comments down below. And of course, if you guys want any of these graphics, I upload all my graphics to Fantasy Labs, fantasylabs.com. Let me just go ahead and pull it up. I did a drop yesterday night where I added a whole bunch of graphics. I think I added like another 500 graphics on there, maybe even 600. And I'm going to keep adding more. I've mentioned this a few days ago, but I'm not going to be just waiting for the 28th of every month to keep dropping graphics. I'm just going to keep overflowing the system with graphics. Right now we have close to right under 5,000. Before we had about 4,000, I added about 200. Then I added last night anywhere from 500 to 600 graphics. We're going to be adding more and more and more. And you guys are free to use them in any way you want. You can edit them. You can use them as is. You don't even have to edit them. It's up to you how you want to use them. So I'll leave a link in the description to Fantasy Labs. As you guys know, I'm only limiting it to 50 total people who actively can use it at a time, because I don't want any kind of customers to complain about, you know, somebody else is using graphics and things like that. And I think limiting it to 50, although other people have access to the same stuff, it will kind of, you know, keep down the copycatting behavior and things like that. It will keep it to a minimum. So yeah, guys, I'll leave the link in the description to Fantasy Labs. By the way, if you are curious, the subscription is $8.99, and there's no other Elements website on the internet today that matches as much content that we offer for the price. I mean, there are people out there who sell a pack of graphics for $5, $6, $7, $8. We have over literally 4,000 graphics, over 4,500 now for $8.99 a month. So you guys check it out. I'll leave links in the description to all the resources, whether it be videos on how to build websites or even fantasy labs. And yeah, guys, hopefully you guys enjoyed this new update with DALL, GPT, and Canva all together. And I think this is super important and super useful. All right. And once again, if you do want to see me tag these designs live, I don't mind creating a video for it here on this channel. All right. Just let me know in the comments down below if that's actually what you want to see. I'll talk to you guys later. Thank you guys for watching, and peace out. Bye.